know we stand today, where we stand was not sacred ground on June the 5th. But that's what it became on June the 6th. The Rangers who scaled this cliff didn't know they would change the world, but they did. I've long said that history has shown that ordinary Americans can do extraordinary things when challenged. There's no better example of that in the entire world than right here at Point du Hoc. Rangers from farms and cities in every part of America, from homes that didn't know wealth and power, they came to a shoreline that none of them would have picked out on a map. They came to a country many of them had never seen, for a people they had never met. But they came. They did their job. They fulfilled their mission. And they did their duty. They were part of something greater than themselves. They were Americans. I stand here today as the first president to come to Point du Hoc when none of those 225 brave men who scaled this cliff on D-Day are still alive. None. But I'm here to tell you that with them gone, the wind we hear coming off this ocean will not fade. It will grow louder as we gather here today. It's not just to honor those who showed such remarkable bravery on that day, June 6, 1944. It's to listen to the echoes of their voices, to hear them, because they are summoning us, and they're summoning us now. They ask us, what will we do? They're not asking us to scale these cliffs, but they're asking us to stay true to what America stands for. They're not asking us to give or risk our lives, but they are asking us to care for others in our country more than ourselves. They're not asking us to do their job. They're asking us to do our job, to protect freedom in our time, to defend democracy, to stand up aggression abroad and at home, to be part of something bigger than ourselves. My fellow Americans, I refuse to believe, I simply refuse to believe that America's greatness is a thing of the past. I still believe there's nothing beyond our capacity in America when we act together. We're the fortunate heirs of a legacy of these heroes, those who scale the cliffs, Point du Hoc, who must also be the keepers of their mission. The keepers of their mission, the bearers of the flame of freedom that they kept burning bright. That is the truest testimonial to their lives. Our actions every day to ensure that our democracy endures and the soul of our nation endures. To come here simply to remember the ghost of Point du Hoc isn't enough. We need to hear them. We have to listen to them. We need to listen to what they had. We need to make a solemn vow to never let them down. God bless the fallen. God bless the brave men who scaled these cliffs. May God protect our troops. God bless America.